All right, guys. Well, we're going to kick things off. So the idea here was, I actually, this is how it kind of started for me anyways. It's funny how YouTube works. And I was just talking to Steve, you know, before we went live here about this, but it's funny how YouTube works, how sometimes your algorithm will change and then you just get bombarded with stuff. And lately it's been all DKOldies for me again. And it's been a while since they've been popping up on my feed. I don't know if they're becoming trendy again, but I was like, you know what, we should do a revisit to the whole DKOldies thing, because that's how we first met. We both covered it quite extensively. I got sick of covering it. I don't know about you, Steve, but it got old for me.
A little bit for me too.
Yeah, but I mean, people liked it. It was a hot topic at the time. So I was going through one of their shorts and I was like, let me just see what the prices are. And it looked pretty crazy. And I was like, let's just do a live stream and kind of go through what they're charging over there. It's funny, they've changed some of their practices. And I do think that's from YouTubers that, you know, highlighted some of the issues here, like you and I. And then, you know, of course, Review Tech USA, who I can't stand, but that's
boo!
Just
boo, thumbs down. I'm ready there for him to leave.
I think it's coming, because he just seems to be unraveling over there. I don't wish anything bad on anybody, but I don't know what's going on over there. It's just it's a cringy sort of channel these days. All right, so we're over here on the DKOldies website. So what we're going to do is I'm going to search for some stuff. Let's dive in here and let's see what they've got going on over here. So we've got, obviously, our consoles. We've got, and they break it down, consoles, and then games and all that stuff. So
yeah, if we start with Nintendo, it's going to be like, it's going to be a slaughter, because everything Nintendo pretty much that they have is bent over the knee expensive. But what's funny too is, like, you know, nowadays with all the stuff that I've seen from resellers on YouTube, DKOldies ain't even the worst option anymore, which is funny, because
no, that's true. And I feel like for a while, at least, because I really haven't been following them at all lately until they just started bombarding my feed now. I did notice that prices did seem to, like, they've never been reasonable or remotely reasonable, but they did seem to go down a little bit, maybe as they were, you know, combating all of the criticism. But let's start off easy then. Let's go into Sega. Although if we go into Saturn, I feel like that's going to be a slaughter too. So maybe we'll just like jump into Dreamcast real quick. And what are they getting for a console these days?
Oh, man.
Damn. Console. Oh, geez. That is $149.99 just for the console only.
Now, hold up. Yeah, I was about to say, like, we got to look at the one with the controller. Yeah. Do they substitute? I don't think people really make third-party Dreamcast controllers. Maybe they do, but
they have retro fighters and stuff like that that are actually pretty good. Mm-hmm. But, yeah, let's see what's going on here. It's not like a PlayStation where it doesn't even say here. So I assume then if it doesn't, well, we can't assume if it doesn't say that we're getting, you know, legit stuff, but.
Gore's in the chat. What's up, Gore? $149.99 and you get Grandma's Dust Bunnies free. That's right, man. Grandma.
Sweet zoom in on this. Pixelation on point.
Yeah, you know, they just pulled it from, you know, the first one that popped up when they
screenshotted Amazon, website. Brought it over. Nice. Yeah, does it say in here? So 100% guaranteed to work. That is always good if you're selling it for an arm and a leg. You want to make sure it works. 1 year return policy. That's good. Yeah. Let's see.
That's really the best part about buying from them. You know, if you're going to have to give them your, you know, firstborn child or like, you know, your entire credit card allowance for an item, then at least they cover it for a year, which is more than you get with some other
places. Yeah, I mean, if you were to buy from, now Phoenix Resale sells on Amazon, right? He doesn't publicly share his store, but on Amazon you only have that 30 day window. I think some things, maybe electronics, it's a little bit more, but it's typically right around there. I mean, that makes you a little uneasy with something like this, which is, what, 25 years old? Easily? More than 25 years old?
Yeah.
So, you know, and are we mentioning refurbished in here? I'm not seeing refurbished in this part, but maybe over here.
No, they say it's in used great condition.
There we go. Status refurbished there on the product detail. Warranty information.
Because they have Sega professionals over there at the DKOldies warehouse.
Naturally, yes.
That are certified to work on these.
Of course. Not including ship. All right. So new unopened product may be returned for refund of the purchase price, not including shipping, within 90 days of the order date. So you can return it in 90 days, but you have, but if it craps out on you anywhere within the year, you're covered. I guess that's the.
So I'm going to keep price charting up to kind of loosely reference what's going on.
Yep.
Someone in the comments, they were saying 70 to 100 on eBay for a Dreamcast. That sounds more like what you would expect, I think.
Yeah. Not console only, though, likely with a controller included.
Yeah. So, I mean,
they're wildly off on
this. And, you know, with the funds that they have, even if they're not getting Dreamcasts traded into them to sell for $200, who's to say they don't just go on eBay? I mean, you've talked about this before in one of your previous videos.
They bought from me on eBay at one point in time, too.
Yeah, to flip. So, I mean, like, you know, they could just be pulling inventory from there and doing the shit.
So what else they got going on over here? We were just talking about how there's there are third-party controllers here, but...
You don't get to decide which one you get, huh?
You just get any of those, and they're so close naturally in design that...
Just rolling the fucking dice. You might get this one that looks
like a mystery box sort of experience here too. All right.
The bottom left, you know, is like a batarang.
That's for the Batman fans right there. But you don't know if you're getting that, so you might end up with this guy over here.
I don't know
what that one is. But you can't. I love the zoom ins though, how they're just
some spaceship looking shit. Gore said spaceship looking shit. Those are the type of controllers you hold them in your hand and you're about to play over at your buddy's house because that's the only extra controller he has. And you just sit there and you look at it and you go, okay, what the fuck am I going to do with this?
I mean, what is this over here, though? Is this a third-party Dreamcast controller in any way, shape, or form other than the fact that we have, you know, the slot in the middle?
It looks more like a modified Genesis controller, but yeah, you can put your memory card.
I don't know if there's not triggers on that. And that's what the two extra, I don't know. I've never seen that, but $19.99 for third party from 25 years old. That seems legit. All right, let's go over to, let's see Genesis. We're going to start easy because once we get to Nintendo, I know it's going to be a disaster. But fan favorite, Sega Genesis, Sonic 2 pack right over here, $129.99. Let's take a look at this.
With the not for resale Sonic 2?
Is that, I mean, I'm trying to zoom in, but... It actually looks better when I don't. So we've got the substitute options here. Substitute an original Genesis 3-button controller for $10. I feel like $10 for a substitute actually for them isn't that wildly outrageous. I mean, I've seen it for...
$5 more for 6 buttons?
Well,
so it's extra. Why are we upcharging on the Sega Genesis controller, but like the more advanced Dreamcast controller is no upcharge? You know, like you just get an original with it.
Well, they are picking us apart with the list price on that one, but I mean we're getting that here too. But we have for games over here because we actually didn't look at Dreamcast games. I want to go back to that, but
Eric, that's awesome, man.
Let's see what we've got going on. Sonic and Knuckles for Genesis, $39.99 over here. Good cartridge. All right, so at least it's not cosmetically flawed. I was thinking that would be the entry with cosmetically flawed.
I'm gonna have to pull that one up on price chart. I loosely follow price chart.
Mm-hmm.
Most of the time it's accurate, but I always double check if it's like
it gives you an idea. And I've talked about that in past videos too, how it can be easily manipulated as well, but it at least gives you a range on there. So
you're $24.99 is what we're looking at for loose on that game.
All right.
How much do they charge for the cosmetic?
I don't know if they have it. Let me go back to it and see if they have a price. They don't. $26.99. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. That's pretty.
$13. I love how it's always different too. Like no matter what you pick, it's a different discount for the shitty one.
Yeah. You know what? I saw a video earlier today and I forget. I think they said they do a 30% discount. I'm not sure. Math is not my strong suit here, but in the video, he said they were basically Joey's little buddy on screen was saying what is cosmetically flawed, and basically Joey said it's anything that, you know, it's not in good condition. So it could be just a little tear, it could be that there's no label at all on the cartridge or the game, so it can be just anything. So dealer's choice there on their end.
I'd be but, returning that shit. If I got like a labelless game, I'd be like, look, yo. As much okay, if you guys
you gotta have some degrees to that for sure. I mean, you can't just
yeah. In quotations though, if you can refurbish consoles, why can't you like reprint labels and shit? I mean, I understand some people probably wouldn't want that, but if it's missing a label completely.
Right. You know. Well, you could specify too. I mean, you don't have to have just cosmetically flawed and good condition. You can list, you know, several different mm-hmm. options for these things. Yeah. And I mean,
that's too much work for them though.
Well, I mean, clearly, I mean, we're using stock photos and they're not even good ones. So mm-hmm. I know I realize that it would be a nightmare to go in here and to, I just want to take a look at Dreamcast games, but to go in and photograph every individual item. But for the prices that you're charging, maybe that is the best approach.
We got Sonic in the house, actually. I feel like Drew tells Joey stuff to say at DKOldies. Yeah, probably. If he even shows up to work to tell Joey.
So oh, Sonic Adventure form. Here for Dreamcast. We've got $49.99 for game only on Sonic Adventure.
Just throw up on that. 50 wow. bucks for a disc?
For a disc. Granted, it is probably one of the most popular Dreamcast games, but...
Probably. Yeah.
$49.99.
You can what tell there are only 11 reviews, so it's not like they're selling that one very often.
True. And what is a game? Wait. All right. So $56.99.
So that's not 30%. I don't
know. No. That is not a big difference at all. $56.99.
I think that Hunter and Joey just kind of throw people bull all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah, 30% would be $17 cheaper.
Well, $69.99 is the list price, but it's on sale. We can save 13 bucks right here, right now, if we pull the trigger. So
that's just
little incentive for us to save 13 bucks right there. That's wild though, and a disc too. So you don't even know. I mean, they're saying that they're not even saying it's good condition, right?
Yeah,
they're not even giving us that much here. I was right, going to say, if it's like flawless and we know it's going to play all the way through, but discs are wildly unpredictable.
Well, they have like, I've seen the video. They got like 10 different disc resurfacer machines. They're all the little $200.
Yeah. Ones. Yeah. The little blue ones that are all, yep. But if that doesn't work, you could always just bring the magic eraser into the mix and just give it a good scrub down that way too. So
that poor Wii. I still think about that Wii sometimes. Oh, 69.69 sold. Should I be shamed for selling to them? No. I mean, hey, if you need money and you need something quick and you don't want to wait for shit to happen.
Oh, here we go. We were talking about top games, Marvel versus Capcom for Dreamcast. Doesn't get any more popular than that, I don't think. That might rival Sonic Adventure. So game only $99.99. You save 25 bucks right here, right now, though. So how much for the $111.99.
I'm still surprised that they're allowed to even do that, because when you constantly false advertise a sale, that's illegal.
Well, everything's always, we haven't seen anything that's not on sale right now.
Yeah, so that game is supposed to be $60 loose and $86.99 complete.
That's a significant difference.
Yeah, but if you ask me, man, I would rather just pay $100 more and get Marvel vs. Capcom 2 on the PS2. Because that's like the best Marvel versus True. Capcom game, in my opinion. I mean, a lot of people share that opinion too.
Yes. Yeah, I believe so. Oh, wow. Sonic Adventure 2, $159.99. And that's game only.
I guess that one didn't sell as well. That was probably like released, you know, that might have actually been one of the last Dreamcast games.
I believe so. I'll just dive into these reviews here a little bit. Sonic, Tails, Knuckles versus Shadow, Eggman. Okay, that's a very detailed one from Joseph there. Thank you for that contribution.
DS
great
collectors.
Price. Fast DS. Service. Very kind and courteous staff. Always available to answer any questions. All right. If that doesn't scream fake review, I don't know what does.
Yeah, how many? Oh, only six reviews for this
six
one.
Reviews.
So, yeah.
They're verified, though, so, I mean... You send them a link with $0 to your buddy, and they leave a detailed review that's verified in their system. It's legit.
All right, DS Collector says he's got to get rid of a kidney and start OnlyFans to afford these prices. That's true.
Have pretty feet.
pretty feet, feet pics.
Or what was the, we both talked to Tim recently, but there was somebody on one of those shows that was selling farts in a jar for like $1,000. We should ask Tim about that. It was one of, the cast members of one of those shows though.
Yeah, I think it was, I hope it wasn't Big Ed. I think he was selling, I think he was selling something else though. I don't even want to imagine that. Like that's really low. Like if you're,
it was a woman. It wasn't a man, but,
right.
ECW Anarchy Rules. I know we're both wrestling fans. $69.99 over here. Game only.
No, they ain't got the case of manual. You're going to have to go somewhere else for that.
I don't remember ECW games. There was one that was decent and the other ones were trash. I don't remember which one was good. Maybe it's this one, but,
Cheesecake
can't be that good.
Yo, go back to that real quick. I noticed something there. Well, you don't have to call me, sir.
Where are we going?
No, go back to that. Now scroll down to the script. Look at the pictures. Oh, wait, never mind. That's related products. Okay. I thought they had multiple pictures and one of them was PlayStation.
Yep.
But yeah, I mean, hey.
We got a 2-star review for the PS1 of this game, though. Let's take a look at the 2-star review that they didn't remove. Because everything else is top notch.
Anarchy sucks, is what they say there. Game only. Oh,
and they got a response. Limited movement in the game. Well, all right. You can't really give DKOldies a bad review for a shitty game unless it doesn't work, and then that's their fault.
Yeah. Hit them with the old copy-paste customer service answer there.
Yep. All right. Well, I'll side with DKOldies on that one. You can't bitch about a shitty game to the person selling it to you.
$30 for Frogger. Somebody saw Frogger for 30.
Frogger's $25.99 for Frogger 2. Where's the original here? Have you ever checked out Caution Seaman? What a bizarre fucking game that is.
I just saw that and I was like, what in the damn hell?
So it's like a walrus person. I only know about it because I had it on my RetroPie and it would be like one of those random video previews that pops up. And I was like, what the hell is this game? Seaman. Never played it, but I watched the video preview and it's very concerning. $34.99 though, so for game only. So if anybody wants to check it out.
You couldn't pay me. Leonard Nimoy is in it. Hopefully he's talking about a different game. No, he's talking about Seaman.
Really?
Gore said that Leonard Nimoy voices in that game, or I guess he's in it. Okay. Now that's crazy. That's probably why that game is like $40.
$69.99. So this is my all-time favorite game, and this, if I'm going to play it on the home console, not arcade, this is the way I would go at it. Game only $69.99. So I actually bought this game here on eBay for I think $24, maybe 3 years ago when I still had my Dreamcast console.
Okay.
So yeah. I don't know what it's going for these days. If you have price charting up, I'd love to see what they're
I'll check it out.
This sucker for, because that just seems crazy to me. To be that expensive on here.
CIB 5386, $40.
And this is okay, and this is game only.
Yeah. $40. Oh. Yeah, I mean, yeah, they could literally be like, man, we don't have any more copies of that. I'll just go buy it for $40 on eBay and then we'll sell it for $70.
I wonder what their turnaround time is, because anytime I bought from them, I just got consoles. I don't think I ever got games from DKOldies. Have you bought games from them?
Yeah, I bought a couple of common titles. So I will say this. I mean, if you're not looking for like a big name title like what we've been looking at, if you're looking for like some basic stuff, you can get stuff for like $10 or less. And I mean, as long as you spend $10 or more, you get free shipping.
Free shipping, right.
There are ways to get good deals on DKOldies, but you're also supporting a company that's willing to basically try to monopolize retro gaming, because that's their... Sure. That's their ultimate goal.
Absolutely.
I haven't bought from them in a while, but I mean, I'm not necessarily saying that you're going to get a bunch of garbage from them. The only console that I ever bought from them ended up being in great shape. So I don't know if I was just lucky that day. I'm typically not lucky. But yeah, so I mean, it's kind of a mixed bag. How much they want for Code Veronica? $64.99? Is that what it said?
$54.99. And that's probably, let's see if that's game only.
I also think it is so stupid. It's so stupid that they always advertise the shittier version of it first. Like game only is what they advertise because it's cheaper. Right.
Yeah, so they get you a click.
Nobody ever is going to choose game only if they already have, or like if they right. don't have like the case and manual already. So
right.
they're always going to want the full thing, you know, because we're not
absolutely
we're yeah. not cavemen. We want shit that looks neat.
Hey, there's no no sale on this one though. I think that's like the first one so far that we don't have a never-ending sale on.
That's the first one I've ever seen like that.
But yeah, you were saying that like the obscure titles, so like NBA 2K, which I actually am familiar with this game, and it's not good in my opinion. But $4.99 for that one, $2.99 over here for NFL, and I'm sure these are just game only. But oh no,
oh no,
oh wait, so they advertise the price for the game that they don't have. Got it. Cool.
Right.
But this isn't outrageous either. I mean, $5 for.
You got to really like Allen Iverson to want that nowadays.
True. Marvel versus Capcom 2. I will look that up. I don't know if I saw that, so let me type it in.
Price charting wants $200 for it, so they're probably in the $260 range. Out of stock on PS2.
Well, it should still give us the price, though. That's $219. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's game only. Okay.
Game only.
$236.99.
I didn't actually look up the Dreamcast value earlier. I looked up the PS version.
Oh, the PS2. Okay.
Yeah.
See what Dreamcast is. Because I was going to say, that's not outrageous for them, but it's probably also not been updated because they probably haven't had it in stock in forever. But
yeah, $199 CIB.
Okay. All right. So they want $199 for game only on the PS2, which they don't have any of them in stock. But we can see.
Yeah, Kisaris.
$219.99 over here.
In America, the prices are crazy. They are because everybody nowadays doesn't want to, like, you know, go about their life like they're supposed to and, like, you know, just work a regular job and shit. They want to step into the gaming hobby and buy a bunch of games and then basically, you know, be a part of the sensational reselling culture. Now you just, you know, it's like, you know, when I was a teenager, everybody was a guitar player. Everybody played guitar. Yep. And I'm just sitting there thinking, I'm like, damn, man, we're all going to need drummers. But there's only so many drummers. So it's the same thing. Like, everybody wants to be a reseller now. Like, it's getting to the point where resellers just sell to each other. So it's like,
this is
what
true.
The heck?
So I just jumped into Saturn, and Saturn's always wildly expensive. But interesting enough, we have $199 for the player pack and $199 for console only over here. So I'm imagining that. Okay, so it is $199 for console only. I bet they have that, like, mislabeling over here then, where they're trying to get you to click, and then it's a different price. Yeah, I mean, so they have one that Joey ran over with his car for $199. That's basically what that would mean if it's acceptable to them. So the good one is $269.99. And I assume that is with a legit controller, not third party, because we don't have any.
Yeah, it says original there.
Yeah.
All product is in good use condition, clean, tested, and backed by our free 1-year warranty.
Sweet.
I wonder when they're going to stop offering that 1-year warranty, though, because they only did that to get out of everybody's hair on YouTube. So, like, eventually that's going to go away, and you're going to have to pay for that, too.
I think the other websites do that, too, so maybe it's now one of those things you have to offer, but, I mean, it's like any... I think warranties in general are a scam for, like, not just gaming stuff, but anything. I mean, there's so many things that they can get out of. So
we got a request to look at some Mario games whenever you get
we're
done
jump
with
over there.
Sega stuff.
Yeah, I just want to look. I want to look at maybe a couple titles here for Saturn. We'll jump over to Nintendo. Not for resale. Virtua Cop, $5.99. Can't go wrong with that. That seems quite low for.
Hey, that one's not on sale either.
No, it's not. Game only, like, $5.99.
And it says not for resale. So it's like, hey, would you like to buy this game that we're not supposed to resale?
But the virtual, but if you want to play through the entire series here that's available for Saturn, you got to pay quite a bit for the Virtua Cop 2. Game only $39.99. But for as far as Sega, I mean, there's some really crazily priced Saturn titles.
Yeah, like
everything
Panzer
that they
Dragon.
Seem to have. Yep.
I know that one's like $1,000 in general. So I wonder how
House much of, I think House of the Dead's up there too, right? Like $600-$700.
It has to be because when people bring up the Saturn, like that's one of the ones they bring up. They're like,
right.
you know,
Earthworm Jim 2, $169.99 for game only, which they don't have. So $204.99 for, you know, game case and manual here. Let me look up House of the Dead.
Make Girl Man cry, dude. Earthworm Jim 2. He's, I mean, that game's kind of pricey on everything, though.
Yeah.
Personally, if I wanted to play it, I'd probably go for the Genesis copy. You can get a loose Genesis copy for like $36. Of course, it probably doesn't look as cool as the Saturn version, but I mean, true. Damn. How cool does Earthworm Jim really need to look for you to have fun?
Very true. Yeah, so it looks like House of the Dead doesn't even come up unless maybe you have to type in the... But I wouldn't think so. So they probably don't even have it. That is a rare one to get your hands on. Yeah. So House of the Dead 2 for Dreamcast, $26.99. And I'm sure that's game only.
Probably,
but
yeah, it's probably $39.99 with the case and manual.
So where are we going with Nintendo, guys? You guys call it and I'll get us over there.
I don't think anybody said anything, but let's just go down the line. Let's go NES. Right.
Cool.
Because, you know, typically NES is kind of cheap, you know.
Should be anyways, right?
Yeah.
What are they getting for a system? And actually, so my first interaction with DKOldies was they bought some, I had some NES consoles that didn't work. They needed to be, I forget what the process is for, you know, cleaning them up and getting them running internally. And I don't have the time or patience for shit like that. So I ended up having two of these in a lot I bought from Goodwill that I listed on eBay, and they bought them for, I want to say $40, maybe $35 a piece, something like that. And I know they just needed a basic, there's like a kit you buy to get them back to life. I forget, been a number of years now, but acceptable is going for $94.99 with third-party NES controllers, which some third parties are, I don't even want to say that. Most not third parties are garbage. Yeah, well, NES third parties are terrible. Like, you couldn't get anywhere. I mean, you would look like, if you're a good Super Mario Brothers player, you would look like me playing that game with the third parties, because I'm terrible at that.
Oh, somebody wants us to check on Chrono Trigger. When we get to the Super Nintendo, we'll check that out.
Okay.
But I tell you what, that is crazy. $109 for an
NES. And then if you want to get the AV to HDMI pack for $25, which these are actually like, I want to say like $7 on Amazon. And they don't even show them here, but because they probably don't want you to go and price check them. But
they're probably better quality, the ones that you buy on Amazon, compared to what they're going to give you. Because they're going to give you that, I can't remember the name of the brand, but it's in yellow boxes typically, and it's just like thin cables. Like it might last you a couple of months if you're using it like a lot.
Even the ones on Amazon are pretty shitty. Like, I did a review on... a tutorial on like something with NES, and I used one of those in the video. So a bunch of people had hit me up and were like, can you send me the link to that? So I sent them a link to it, and it turned out that the quality I had must have been like the cutoff on when it was actually good, because I still have mine and it works. Everybody else, like, it was like comment after comment, to the point where I just took the link out because everybody was saying that it broke after like 2 days. So that's, you know, with third-party electronic cables like that, that's kind of what you're getting yourself into.
Yeah.
But they probably paid $5, not $25. So, yeah, $133.99 for everything that you would need with the original acceptable controllers, which is two of them, is a $14 markup. That seems way off. I mean, you should be paying under $100 for all of this. Probably, just guessing, I don't have price charting in front of me, I would say probably like $65. I don't know, somewhere around there.
Yeah, you know, it's just, it might just be me, but if I was going to play NES games and I wanted to play the actual games, I would use the Retron 5. Because, I mean, you can buy a Retron 5 brand new for $150 to $200 brand new. And it plays, you know, NES, Super Nintendo, Sega Genesis. You could play the Master System if you buy an additional attachment. And it plays Game Boy and Game Boy Color and Game Boy Advance. And, you know, if you're just trying to play something, you'd be better off doing that. Because, I mean, obviously you pay that $200 for that thing, it's going to play the games.
Sure.
Now, I know a lot of people are sticklers for original stuff, which is totally cool. But, you know, definitely don't buy it from DKOldies if you do want to play that stuff. You know, obviously you can buy it cheaper somewhere else.
All right, we're going to move on to the next console. Actually, we didn't jump into games here, so I guess we should jump into a couple of NES titles.
Hit up that
titles.
Mario. Yeah.
All right. Oh, Super Mario What do we got? $29.99 for Super Mario Brothers 2. Super Mario Brothers 3.
Super Mario 2, that's the one that everybody doesn't like because it's different.
Right.
It's more like an RPG.
This is this is a good one. Super Mario Brothers 3. Good cartridge, $34.99. Cosmetically flawed is going to be, they like that 30% off, so $18.99 here. Which actually, it's marked down from what the good cartridge is selling for.
Yeah, so $19 for a loose copy.
Why would they both be the same list price, though? I mean, I think that right there proves your point that everything's always on sale because they're just listing this to get you over to this price, you know, with their whatever goes into that logic on their end.
I just don't understand why a company that wants to advertise a luxurious kind of retail experience for retro gaming, they want to sell you the crappy stuff first. Like, that's what they're advertising first. I guess maybe they feel like if they had CIB stuff advertised first that people wouldn't buy from them. But I don't think that's the reason why people wouldn't buy from them. I think there's plenty of other obvious reasons.
I mean, it's crazy that a lot of people do buy from them, though. And I mean, not everybody's on YouTube to see. I think YouTube is what's really highlighting the negatives about DKOldies. But I have to think that you're getting a lot of, I realize that some games are fairly priced in that if you're looking for, like, I'm into stuff that's not super popular. So I'm sure there's some reasonably priced stuff on here for like Xbox and stuff like that, that wouldn't be outrageous. But I have to think that like the majority of people on here buying are probably people that aren't informed on, you know, true values of things. And they're looking for just one stop shop to kind of grab everything that they're looking for, maybe for gifts or whatever. So most of this stuff, like we're talking about not super popular titles. A lot of this stuff is more obscure. $46.99 for Kirby's Adventure here. Good cartridge.
$46.99.
So they're knocking $3 off, though.
I mean, hey, you know, you got to really love Kirby. You know, I feel like you could buy like three other Kirby games for different systems for that same amount of money, though.
Sure. Yeah, I would think so. I mean, if this isn't a reason to run over towards emulation, I don't know what is. Especially now. Have you actually tried the... do you have an iPhone?
I do have an iPhone. I have an iPhone.
Have you tried the Delta emulator yet?
I haven't. I'm kind of not really into the emulation thing anymore now that I can afford the games I want.
Yeah.
Now, granted, if I ever wanted to play like Little Samson or something, I would emulate that. But that's just because it's not available for cheap. Mm-hmm. They should add it to NSO, honestly.
Well, if you like Pokemon games, though, I mean, you're not going to pay. Do you have Pokemon for like the Game Boy Color and all that stuff? Where they're,
I guess, a few of them. Yeah.
Yeah, they're pretty pricey for that stuff.
Not CIB. I mean, I have Yellow, Gold, Silver, and Blue, and Red. But I've been playing Scarlet like on the Switch. So, and I play Pokemon Go all the time.
Sweet.
So I got plenty of Pokemon going on in my life. I also collect the games, or not the games, the cards. I don't play the physical cards, but I collect them because they have really sweet artwork.
All right, so we've got Super Nintendo here. We've got the fan favorite World Pack, $259.99. Sweet deal there. Oh, it comes with the game. Okay.
$260. Never in my life.
But that's with those third party controllers. Those
so we get a $20 upcharge per controller.
Well, twenty per controller. And if you want to get that AV to HDMI, you got to add another $25 on there for $324.99. It better look just like that picture right there. We don't want any tan lines on there. No yellowing for a cool $324.99. That is that might be the priciest option here for consoles that we've combed through so far.
I mean, think of it this way. You could pay $300 for a brand new Switch and then get a year of their online for $20.
I was going to say, it's less than that, yeah.
And not only play Super Mario World, but play like 100 other games. So, and you know, if you can't get your nostalgic fix out of 1 year of that service, then I mean, maybe you should buy from DKOldies.
That's yeah, that is wild right there.
My talk
fan
about
favorite. Germany. I like fan favorite. I like how they're using that. But an acceptable option. Can we do the same thing, just going acceptable? And that acceptable. That's gonna be like a yellow console, I have to imagine, right? Because probably, these are known for being as yellow as the add to cart button right here. If you know if they've been left out to I forget the proper term for what that discoloration is, but you can actually, what's strange to me though, is that you can actually remove that very easily. I've done it many times. So I'm not sure. Light? Yeah. And it doesn't take much. Use the, what is it? The hydrogen peroxide. You coat it on there. Obviously you got to take everything apart. That's probably why they don't do it. Cause you
right,
don't want to do that
take
while
stuff
there's
apart. Yeah.
Right. You don't want to do that with, you know, everything seeping into the internal components, but it is an easy process, and you have to put it in the UV. You could leave it overnight in the UV lights, and it'll come out almost brand new in most cases. I mean, if you got like a really bad one, then maybe you have to do a couple of treatments, but it does come out really nice.
It's only a $10 upcharge for original controllers here. So what does that mean? Does that mean they're going to give you a messed up original controller?
It's to offset what they're going to send you with a console here. I don't know.
Yeah, Bandit says he's done it with sunlight and hydrogen peroxide.
Yep.
You know, maybe they just don't do it with the UV lights because they spent their entire repair budget on the disc resurfacer machines.
There you go. All right. So, what's some games we should look up here? We guys see Donkey Kong Country. That's probably my favorite Super Nintendo. $29.99. I feel like that's not outrageous for them, and it's a good cartridge. I mean, it is high. It's one of those games where they certainly had an abundance of those, but
yeah, we also need to check out Chrono Trigger. So okay. I think Chrono Trigger currently is around the $200 mark.
Okay. Let's see.
One of the best RPGs ever made.
Let's see.
$224.
I missed the H on that one, but okay, and it doesn't look like they have.
It's going to be that one to the left. That's the left. Complete. They want $1,000 for that, though. They're
smoking
crack.
Well, I'm glad I clicked on that one.
Price chart.
Well, they did want it, but apparently somebody bought it at that price, so they're out of stock.
Oh man. Yeah, one of their fake review guys bought it.
They got four reviews on that one.
No, Richard, it's not because of smoking around the
$319.99 for a good cartridge, Chrono Trigger.
Yeah, so I mean, how are they out of stock on that? Because they could, I mean, I know their ass could go on eBay and buy it for $224.
So that's the thing. Like, so they could just go on and they could buy whatever they wanted. So if they just put somewhere in here that their lead time on orders can vary, then they could just simply list anything on here as in stock and then just go out and get it, do a buy it now. I mean, a buy it now on eBay is probably going to be significantly lower than this price to where it is worth their time. Hell, they could even drop ship it if they talk to the seller, but they probably don't want to do that. Because when I sold to them, they bought a Mario Kart Double Dash from me for GameCube for, I think it went for like $75 or so, which I was thrilled with. I think that's the true value of it. But they were turning around and flipping it for like $1.30.
Wow.
So it's not, I mean, that's not a bad deal for literally just unboxing it and then, you know, putting it in another padded mailer when somebody buys it from their website. They didn't have to do anything to it. It was in good shape. So, all right. So what's some other titles we should look up over here for,
Someone suggested Final Fantasy 3 or 6, whichever for Super Nintendo. I think that's going to be Final Fantasy 3.
Gore says search within here.
Yeah. A convention near me had an inbox chrono for $400 back in 2016. I kicked myself for not getting it. I mean, yeah, that would have been great. At least, you know, if you're balling on a budget, you can get the complete DS version for like $113 according to price chart. Also, have they added that to NSO yet? They need to put that one on there.
I don't think so.
They need to put all the Pokemon games on there too, because it's getting ridiculous.
Right. $119.99 for Final Fantasy III for Super Nintendo. That's a good cartridge.
What do they want for the cosmetically flawed?
Cosmetically flawed, $79.99.
So, I mean, that might be 30% off.
Yeah, that seems about right. Somewhere in that ballpark, at least.
Yeah, that game's supposed to be $78. So that one's only
in good shape.
Yeah, well, just loose $78. Loose,
yeah.
I would imagine that most price charting values are based on sales, and most people would probably buy the good condition ones first.
Right. Makes sense. All right. Let's go to a different console here. Let's jump into N64, which is always a good one. So what are they getting for an N64? And this, they always have a lot of variations with the fan favorites or the most populars here. So acceptable is $89.99. Now, does that come with a... Of course, it doesn't come with a $25 markup for an original N64 controller.
For one, see, that's got to be the most expensive controller
markup.
Yeah,
that's the most we've seen. We saw 20 before with Super Nintendo, and that had been the highest. So,
wow. Yeah,
25. Yep. So $114.99 for acceptable. What drives me nuts about this though is that you don't know what acceptable to them. That could mean that. Yeah. I mean, so I. This was my first experience with them. Was I bought an N64 console, and it was it wouldn't work. And I think what ended up happening was what was it? The jumper pack, I think, was I don't think, I know it was third party. So it's likely that was part of the issue. But I mean, I couldn't get it to even fire up. So I don't know.
Will said he bought Chrono Trigger sealed at a yard sale for $1 and resold it for top dollar. Now I know that motherfucker is lying. He better be. After I done plugged PlayStation 8 Dead earlier, don't make me take it back now. Don't hurt James and Sean because of your mistake. Super bowling for the 64. Man, what a. How, did you know about this bowling game on the 64 that's like $700 or $600?
No, I don't.
And it's garbage too. It's terrible.
Really?
So, just like Clay Fighter Sculptor's Cut. I mean, Smash Bros for 45 ain't bad, but of course that's going to be cosmetically flawed. I think that one goes for around $50 in general.
Good cartridge, $69.99. Cosmetically flawed is the $44.99. Yep.
That's such a good game. But why would you pay $60 for that when you could buy the best, like the one with every character ever for less than $60, which is the Switch version.
True. Oh, I feel like with four controllers, we got to check this one out, the Golden Eye Pack.
Yeah, so the markup surprisingly isn't that bad on that Smash. It says Smash is about $40 and they sell it $44.99 cosmetically flawed. So that's really not that bad compared to other shit.
Well, if they watch this video, they're going to jack that price up now. So
yeah,
we just gave them an assist on that one.
They better not. They better not.
So, all right. So we saw that the original controllers were $25 a piece over here because I guess you're getting, you know, a bundle of four of them. They're going to knock it down $5 per unit to a cool $20. So,
yeah. Oh, how nice.
60-80. Nice.
How nice of them.
$20 savings.
Sonic says Diddy Kong Racing is better than Mario Kart 64. I definitely agree with that. Diddy Kong Racing is the GOAT.
Way more to it. Yeah. Yep.
On N64.
Absolutely.
Charlie Murphy in the house. What up, bro? I know that guy in real life. He's cool.
Nice. So $319.99 for the N64 GoldenEye pack if you want the original controllers, but you're going to have to figure out your AV to HDMI if you're not using a CRT. Well, I suppose there's some TVs out there that will still accommodate that. What else do we have here? Super Smash Kart pack, $264.99. I guess we got to check out the price of...
I tell you Mario what, if you use one of those HDMI adapters playing four-player split screen on an HD TV on GoldenEye, you're going to be sitting there like Mr. Poopy Butthole from Rick and Morty, just, ooh! You know, you're gonna be having a horrible time.
Hey, these are, they're giving you the discount here without the bulk discount, so you get...
Well, son of a bitch!
Yeah, instead of $25 a piece, only 20 over here. That's because you're indulging in the Mario Kart 64 and Super Smash Brothers. So
that's Pitbull right there, Mr. 305.
There you go.
Yeah, we're gonna need $305 for you to have nostalgic fun. They probably only give people like $60 for that console.
Probably.
And that's what really fucks the whole thing about it is because people will trade it in with the original controller, and then they go, let's put that to the side.
And right. This, upcharge time.
This shitty one, the Circa. Give them the Circa 64 controller.
Yeah, because you can get the N64 third-party controllers in bulk for like $2. It's crazy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you did a video on that too.
Yep. So Mario Kart 64, we've got cosmetically flawed for $50. $69.99 for the good cartridge. And nothing in the box for these.
See, that just blows my mind. Like, why would you pay $70 for that when you could play Mario Kart 8 Deluxe for less money? And it has all of those maps pretty much remastered. So,
Or you can play it on your iPhone now for free. I just did that the other day with my, where's that controller? Can't beat free for Mario Kart 60. I mean, I would go that route. I know it doesn't hit the same way for those looking for the pure nostalgia of it, but I mean, $70 in my pocket is much better in my opinion.
Double Dash is better for sure. These prices are fucking whack. I agree with that. Is this a joke?
So what else? Looking at
a reel from the 90s, right? A reel from the 90s. Maybe. I will never DKOldies.
NFL Blitz, $37.99. $37.99.
That's a good game, but you know, like,
it is, yeah.
You could buy the arcade cabinet for like $200.
They got the legacy now. That's what this Indiana Jones mod is. Its core, but yeah, you know, no, they want a fortune for that from Arcade One Up.
Yeah, I think I have one of the Blitz games on 64.
Loose, it shouldn't be. It shouldn't be $27.99 loose. I'll tell you that much. But I think I actually have one of those too. I don't have an N64 anymore, but
yeah, I have Blitz 2000 right here. It's fun, you know.
Yeah. I like the original probably a little bit more, but all the Blitz games, I don't think there's a bad one. Even the GameCube ones, I love those. 2002, 2003.
The PS2 ones are good too. The Blitz Elite.
Yeah. Yep.
Yeah. That's what Gore was just talking about that. Yeah, I think I have at least one or two of those.
See if there's anything else outrageous here. WWF Attitude, $7.99.
Hey, that's actually the Dreamcast game I have.
Okay.
That's the one Dreamcast game I have. And I paid about
$11.99 when you actually get to it, because they bring you to the good cartridge as always. But yeah, that wasn't one of my favorites. For N64, you got to go. If you're going WWF, you got to go No Mercy. And then WCW and NWO Revenge.
Hold up. Go back up. Superman 64. It's going to be on your left column there.
This one right here? 12.
11 reviews, 4.5 stars. That's the worst game on 64.
Well, they're reviewing the experience, Steve, not the game.
No. I want to see these fucking fake ass reviews here. I never thought to
look. Game of Steel.
Raising a baby girl and trying to start her off with some old gyms. Wonderful game. Okay, now I know you're full of shit. John B.
I like Pursuing right here. That's a good one.
We got John B. and John J. Oh, my goodness. They didn't even try with this.
And JBJ or JB, JBV down here.
Yeah.
You can tell your friends that you played it. All right.
These reviews are about as valid as a Boomer Sauce video. Batman is the worst on 64. I never played Batman on the 64.
Batman's got some duds, but I don't think that I've played it on there either. Ken Griffey Jr. Slugfest, only $13.99.
You know what's a good Batman game though, from like retro days?
What's that?
Batman Returns on the Super Nintendo.
That is a good one.
It slaps.
What's the one for Saturn? Oh, it's the arcade. I think it's the arcade port, right? I think I actually have that up on my pinball. Yeah, Batman Forever.
Yeah, Batman Forever on the Genesis, one of the worst games of all time. That's what Gore says. I agree.
I can't get anywhere in that game.
But then again, that game was based on a horrible movie, so you couldn't really expect it to be too good.
Let's see what Revenge is going for. I don't think we saw that one yet, because that's probably one of my all-time favorites. Just $12.99.
Just $12.99
for cosmetically flawed.
$20. I have that one. CIB. It's like right up there.
Yeah, that doesn't seem that outrageous. All right.
Yeah, it's not too bad.
Probably it's always the stuff that I like, though, but that is a popular one. So,
well, you know, too, is like, if you go look at No Mercy, because everybody's always like, No Mercy, No Mercy, No Mercy, No Mercy. Like, that's sure, the one that everybody's that like, for. Oh, man, if you're playing 64, you got to play No Mercy, man. You know? Yeah, look at
$4.99 right here, if you want this one.
Yeah. And there then, like, the one that has the save problem, they're still charging $50 for. I need to see if that's the one I have. I doubt it, but
$52.99 for regular one and good cartridge. What's that one valued at? Because that seems I know it's everybody's go-to, and I'm not knocking it. It's definitely one of the best games, but
Batman Begins loose, for PS2 $30. Is good. Retro Rick is a cake eater. The worst game ever is E.T. on Atari 2600. I mean, hell yeah. I mean, that would stop the whole situation for a few years.
Yep.
Playing the Spectrum this weekend on emulation. Hell yeah.
What do we got for GameCube over here? Now, I bought one of these from them. It was the Platinum, though. These prices are actually up from what they were then. I think I paid...
Man, you used to be able to get a GameCube for like $50.
I mean, they're known for being a little problematic too. Definitely sensitive. Yeah,
so look at that.
Well, you got a lot of options here. You can substitute. You can get spicy over here with the spice controller for $30.
Give me that spicy boy, $30. What color is that? Red, I guess.
Or is it the orange?
The Muy Caliente is going to cost you $30, man.
$5 extra for it. Platinum's 25, which the Platinum is hard to keep from getting all dinged up because it starts to really wear down with that finish. Your Indigo and Black are probably your best bets. But yeah, I don't know why you would want one of those with a Platinum. I'm actually surprised that they don't mark up the Platinum with the Platinum because, you know, that's a set. Wouldn't be beyond them to try to squeeze you for an extra $5 with that.
Right.
All right. And this is refurbished controller optional. Okay. All right. So what about an Indigo over here? So acceptable is $129.99. So acceptable is $129, but $30 and you get a good one. I don't even see an Indigo right here. $189 for that one. So wow, $30 more for
to go Indigo. I love how they advertise Indigo player pack, but if you want the Indigo controller to go with the Indigo player pack, you got to pay $25 extra bucks.
Yeah. Yep.
Yeah, that's really
so crap. that makes it over north of 200. Yeah, $214.99, and then of course you got your AV to HDMI for $25 if you want to go that route. You'd have to be out of your mind to do that.
Yeah, Keesera said they sell cheap-ass controllers, and they say they don't sell fake games. Yeah, that's another thing, too, man. They say that all their consoles are authentic, but then they sell Retrons, which Retrons are fine. Yep. You know, they get the job done, but that's not a legitimate official console.
No. No, and the GameCube third-party controllers are probably the worst third-party controllers out there on the market, in my opinion. I mean, they're just absolute shit. So... what else we have here? I mean, we have a lot of variations, and then they're bundling games, so you can get up to $359.99. Looks like the highest price so far over here, and that's for Mario Kart. Let me see if that's is that the game's loose? So it doesn't even say.
I tell you what, if it was loose, I'd be spitting on somebody because they have the cases there.
But right, again, but they have the cases on the loose ones too.
Yeah, exactly. I
it
don't
doesn't
know.
Say, right? Does it say down here? To Super Mario. No, it just says games. It doesn't even say.
I would be
very good.
I'd be extremely pissed.
You're leaving a lot up in the air right there for $359.99 with a set of third party controllers.
Yeah, so roughly $400 if you want authentic controllers. $400, man. Dude, you know, it really wasn't that long ago that $400. It really wasn't that long ago where $410 was a lot of money. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
Like 10
I mean,
years
you can
ago.
Get a PS5 for that now or thereabouts. So.
I know. That's what's crazy about this whole thing, man.
Yeah, so we're going back. When did this come out? 2002, 2001, somewhere around there. So we're 22 years old on this console, and if we get the original controllers there as well. Now, imagine you get just discs for these. Those little, just two little ass discs in an envelope. Probably in the same envelope to save money for
Yeah, that would be.
$409.99.
No,
That
no
would
way in
be,
hell,
let
man.
me, listen, I'm not putting up $409.99 to find out, but wouldn't that be a hit video if somebody did, for anybody else out there that wants to throw 409 out there into the air? That would be something if they actually sent you just two discs of two little discs in this bundle for 409,
And also,
because it
I
doesn't
pointed
say
this
anywhere that
out.
they don't.
And you don't get a memory card. You know, that none of
No,
these
no,
offer
no.
memory cards.
What
But
are we
I
getting
pointed
for a
this out in
memory
the
card?
video before. Sometimes their bundles are more expensive than just buying the stuff
Piecing it
individually.
together, yeah, going
Yeah.
a la carte.
Yeah, they just, you know, you're paying them extra for a convenience, I guess. That's absurd. $220 for that disc.
These are rare. They are hard to find, but yeah, 220 for this. We've got 14 reviews, so there's at least lost disc. Yeah, that would be a problem.
Paul asked me what I'm vaping. Right now it is Custard Monster Butterscotch. It's pretty
You didn't
good.
have a
I like.
cheesecake for us?
No, not today, man. Not today. I'm slacking, man. But yeah, it's pretty good, man. It tastes like custard with a little bit of a butterscotch taste to it.
New platinum GameCube on eBay for 4 grand. So that's in the box then, sealed up and everything. I have to imagine, right?
Yeah, well, surprised it isn't graded and selling for 20,000.
That's true. Well, yeah, there's another video for you. You could do that. So yeah, if you wanted to get the disc here, you also have to get this guy over here, right? If you don't already have the base, because
Yeah,
these
so
go together,
$300
right?
for the pair. Do they
Or is
have
it
good
more when you click
condition?
on it?
Good
It's in good condition.
accessory.
The so $59.99 if you want one. That's
Wow, like almost half the price.
yeah.
That's stupid.
I have to think that most of those are going to be in acceptable condition because that platinum just does not hold up. Like all the edges on the console itself end up getting worn down to just like, the original plastic color. They just don't hold up well at all. What else do we have? So, I mean, they have 3 pages of just consoles. You can get a skin wrapped one. I mean, they don't have it in stock, but what's that go for?
Sean, you better not buy that GameCube just to open it, man. That dude's crazy, man. He has way too much cash to blow on shit. Do not buy that. If you do, though, and you open it, you got to put it on YouTube, man.
Absolutely.
So that I can hate comment on your video.
So they don't have any of the spicy GameCubes, but let me just see what they charge for these.
Orange
Interesting
spice.
that they're, yeah, 179, and that's for
You can't even get
but
the.
they only they won't
How
even
does that make sense? You can do it on the other one, but you can't do it
Right.
here.
They don't like the combination of those. They only want to give you the platinum in acceptable condition. They've deemed it to
GameCube
look
cheap.
best with this color, and that's all they want to offer you.
Man, I swear, dude, they don't update this
No
stuff at
logic,
all.
no. I didn't
They're
even know that
probably.
they did all these. I've seen a lot of skins for GameCubes on like Etsy. They're real big and stuff. I didn't know that they were. Obviously, they went through a period of time where they were doing that.
I mean, Drew probably sits at his desk with his cup of coffee with plenty of milk and sugar in it, you know, where it's basically not even coffee anymore. And he probably just sits on his phone and he just listens to the dings on eBay and on his website. And he's like, well, as long as the cash keeps cha-chinging, I don't need to do anything with my website.
This has to be old here. I feel like they'd be charging way more than that for this whole
Oh,
setup right
yeah.
here.
Nowadays, for sure.
Yeah. All
And
right,
look at
so
that.
let's
They
go to.
actually took a photo.
Yeah. That's how
That's
you know it's
crazy.
old school. That's from the eBay days. I want to see what they're charging for a Wii console because this has got to be the most affordable console that you can get in this day and age. I
Well,
mean,
I
these
don't know.
shouldn't
Somebody
be.
in the comments were saying earlier that the prices have started going up on these.
Probably because people are modding the hell out of them now and
Yeah.
bringing emulation into them, but $64.99 for
Later,
for
Jim.
acceptable. Holy crap. $64.99 acceptable. people with and they're doing knockoff Wii remotes now.
So I 74 have a, I actually I have a third party Wiimote that a friend left at my house. They're not too bad, but I mean, dude, like, come on. There's
these
like
aren't over that hard to find, though.
There's over 100 million Wii systems, so there, that means right. there's at least 100 million Wiimotes, plus all of the additional yeah. ones they sold.
Right.
So,
I mean, you can get one for I want to say like $18 or so. Maybe on Amazon it's like $25, but eBay you right. should be able to get one in decent shape for like $18. So they're charging. I guess that's not that bad then. If they're going to give you a, I mean, they're making their money off the console, and this is acceptable condition. But $10, they're giving you the original white controller, as they want to call it, and a nunchuck.
White controller.
They let Joey do the listing that day. So most popular.
Poor Joey. I tell you what, man, Joey. You know he probably smokes 2 or 3 packs of cigarettes a day, man.
He's got to.
You could just look at him and go, man, that guy's got some stained fingers from cigarette smoke.
So we've got the most popular here. Now this one is in
only $5.
Only $5, right? For the white controller yeah. and nunchuck.
Consistency, not yeah. not a value shared at.
Well, they're giving you $5 less because you're paying a shitload more for a better console.
Right.
So they didn't run the
I mean, hell, if all controllers were upcharged $5, they'd probably sell a lot more of them, but they probably don't yeah. want to do that because they don't want to run out.
Yeah, they didn't put the magic eraser over this one, so you know they're gonna get for it.
There's no guarantee that they didn't do that either. You know, they probably did.
Did they ever respond to that one? I think that's one. Usually they came back with like a little vague response like weeks later after we would do a video talking shit about them. I don't think they ever came back from that one. There was no making that work. And for those that don't know, basically they did a video on how when all of us were talking about how they don't refurbish, their response was to do this short, I think it was a short video, where they said, no, we refurbish, we open up all of our consoles, and then they cut to this lady that is just wiping down a Wii console with a magic eraser. For those that don't know, mm-hmm. magic erasers are essentially like sanding sponges. They yeah. are super gritty. She did have it wet, but it doesn't matter if you wet it. And I did a video like demonstrating it with a, I think it was a panel of a Wii console. And yeah, it just basically takes off the entire sheen. So you end up with this matte finish at the end, even if you lubricate the hell out of it.
And they probably don't magic erase the entire thing, so it definitely looks blotchy.
Right, so you just have these random spots that have absolutely no gloss to them anymore.
Wii Sports is a reseller's favorite game. We should definitely check out Wii Sports whenever we go to the game side.
Sure.
Also, Sean in the comments, Videodrone, said that third-party Wiimote controllers left at your house are called dildos. No. More like dildonts.
Good to know. All right, so and they have I'm seeing Wii U's in here as well, and I believe that these yeah so they just kind of mix it up there. What do they want for a Wii U controller? Only $200 for the gamepad only.
Oh geez, dude.
Oh,
you can get a whole Wii U for $200.
They have the Zelda edition. Oh, it's the Zelda oh. edition. Okay, so even that, $139 okay, so is crazy. It should be. I got one of these not that long ago because I had the console without the gamepad. I want to say like should be under $100.
Yeah, I tell you, Nintendo really messed up not selling the gamepad separately. Like that was the whole thing that yeah. kind of sucked about it. It's like if you want to play with a gamepad over at somebody else's house and they're right. using their gamepad, you've got to bring yours. Or I don't even know if you can link two to the same console.
I don't think you can. I don't think yeah. so.
Because it probably couldn't handle that kind of stream.
Right.
Because, I mean, even when you were doing the tablet gaming on it, you could mm-hmm. only go like 20 feet away from the console before it started acting.
Oh, yeah. 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 Started shitting the bed. Up. Yep. All right. Well, you wanted to go to Wii Games, right? Let me go back over there.
Yeah. Only if it's Super Bowling. Hey, you could play whatever bowling game you need to, man.
All right. So, Wii Games.
Yeah, okay, yeah. Only one gamepad at a time. Well, if you were the guy with the gamepad, you were having a great day. That's for sure.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, so $17.99 for Super Mario Galaxy. That doesn't seem... Why? Oh, of course, it's game only. $26.99 for...
That's cheaper than everything. Phoenix resale.
It is, yeah. I thought it would be more than that.
No, that's a good game. Okay. You know what's funny too?
What was I looking for? Jake. Bowling on here?
No, Wii Sports. Yeah.
Wii Sports. All right, yeah. So for the almost $40 bucks here. $40 I remember when this here. Was when this was really a cheap option because I mean the console came with this game, right? Early on.
Yep. Every copy of that
every
system other than I think the red edition came with it. And the red one might even came with it.
There should be a lot of these out there, so that whole supply and demand sort of thing, I guess, doesn't play into this.
Oh yeah. Plus they made the Nintendo Selects. They made the $20 greatest hits version, which is the same game.
That's right.
So there are over 100 million copies of this game in existence. At the bare minimum, there's 100 million.
Yeah.
That's a gate kept game because Tetris, you know, they made a bunch of that and you could buy Tetris on the Game Boy for like $10. And I know there's not that many people out there trying to buy Wii Sports.
Only $2.99 for Link's Crossbow Training over here. So a lot of people don't know about this game, actually.
That's the one that came with that accessory. So that was a pack in, but that one, look, that one's only $6.
Yeah, for the case, cover, art, manual.
Yeah, price chart.
That was a sleeve, right? That's just the insert, right? Yeah.
Yeah, it's just
because it came with the. Yep. I'm surprised that one's not like, I don't know, $70 or something crazy.
Yeah, Wii Sports on price chart is $21.25.
Is this the Resident Evil that has that attachment for the Wii Remote? Because there's a couple Resident Evils.
Talk about the Wii Motion Plus. Or was it like a gun?
It was like a gun and a knife. Let me see if I can look it up.
I don't remember that.
Yeah, I saw it. Not that it was a gun, but they also had like a blade sort of attachment.
Yeah, exactly. Perfect Storm. Yeah, 100 million. That's 1/3 of the U.S. It's a little under 1/3, but I mean, the point still stands. There's a lot of Wii Sports out there.
Yeah, so it's a Resident Evil Magnum Blaster with knife for Wii. And I'm not sure which game it's for. I'm trying to look that up here. Let me see if I can pull you guys over to this page because I don't think you guys can. Oh, yeah, you guys can. Let me see if I can do this. Testing out my tech skills over here now.
I was about to say, man, you're supposed to be the tech guy.
Supposed to be. I don't know if it lets me do two different ones at the same time. So I got to get rid of that.
Email Rich and be like, "Hey, I'm gonna take over as Review Tech USA."
Just give me your dad's email address. I'd like to talk to him real quick. Yeah. Here you go. There we go. Yeah. So did you ever see this? So you have it for the nunchuck. You have the blade for the nunchuck, and then you have
sweet.
The Magnum. These are a pretty penny. I think I saw
I've
one.
I've never seen that.
Yeah, I saw one on eBay. I want to say it went for like $150.
That must have been very limited because I worked at GameStop at the time that game came out, and I never seen that. So I don't know. That's pretty cool, though.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, I only saw it come up once. So let me see if I can get back to.
It might have also been limited released because it has a knife.
Very true, but it was a different time. Well, this was what would have been like 06, 07.
Jackson has read my previous comment about DKOldies. Okay, let me go back. They are overpriced on everything I say too, but I was okay with the price for them. I mean, hey, shop where you want to, man. I got official Nintendo Power Strategy Guide for Ocarina of Time from DKOldies recently for $50 and Goldeneye for $20. I will say great condition and decent price, I feel, and I was surprised. I mean, hell, if it was like your first purchase with them, I know they give you like 10% off. And like I said, I mean, it's not always horrible to buy from them. You can get decent stuff for decent prices. But the consoles and the main stuff like Mario and Pokemon and Sonic apparently can be a little pricey, and you have better alternatives for those titles. But if you're looking for stuff that's not really as desired, then you might be okay shopping with it. But then again, like I said, if you buy from them, you're supporting a company that doesn't have the greatest reputation with how they treat their consoles. From what I've heard, they have great customer service. So, I mean, I'll give them that. I'm not saying don't buy from them, but I'm just saying I'm not going to buy from them ever again.
So I was going to just kind of prove that point, but and say that you can get obscure titles for reasonable prices. So this is an obscure title that I love. Not many people do, but game only is $25.99. So I just bought this not a couple months back for, I think, $12 complete. So, yeah, so much for that. I was going to actually try to defend them a little bit and say you can get good deals. And you can. You're absolutely right. But, yeah, this didn't turn out to be a good example because they're looking for double the price for, right, you know, the exact same thing.
Well, also, I just think Xbox stuff is a little hot right now, like the original stuff.
It is. And maybe Indiana Jones was I think I'm the only one that really cares about Indiana Jones. But actually, my next guest on Friday cares about Indiana Jones. He has an Indiana Jones specific channel. So,
wow.
Plug that. Throw that plug right in there.
Yeah, Rogue Daddy says, Steve, shut your mouth. Don't buy from DKOldies ever. I won't. Consoles from there are a joke. I tell you what, look up like Gran Turismo 3 for the PS2. I bet you that game is less than $10. And that's a fantastic game. No D. It might still pull it up though.
Yeah, it should.
Nope.
Went to the wrong.
You gotta be went precise. To a wrong hole.
I'm not precise. I'm
the tech guy over here. Yeah, I'm sure this game's less than $10. If it's more, I'll be surprised. Yeah, look, $3.99.
$3.99.
Yeah.
Disc only. So
probably $5.99 with the shit.
Oh, $3.99. There you go.
Yeah, that's not too bad. That's the game case and cover art. So if you want it with the manual, it's probably $4.99, I would imagine. Yeah.
There you go.
So I mean, if you're looking for stuff like that, that's good. You could buy that there for $5. They've probably resurfaced it. Because the chances of you finding that in the wild for like good condition may be a little harder to do, especially nowadays since everybody is a reseller now. But yeah.
Plus you can bundle it with other things. If you can comb through their site and you can find 5-6 titles that are priced reasonably, bundle them together, you get the free shipping. Yeah, I can definitely see going that route because you're getting it from one source, not having to go on eBay, pay separately for shipping and all that. Plus all the fees now. At the end of the day, I mean, not much has changed. I suppose you could find some deals. You really got to struggle to locate them, but I don't know. At least they changed the whole sticker thing. You saw the short they just did somewhat recently.
Yeah.
Now they're claiming that those never voided warranties or anything, even though we all have it.
Those are just to identify our products.
That's right. Even though, who was it? You did a video on him. I'm blanking on his name. The only guy that Review Tech will ever shout out in his videos, Jacob R. He had the screenshots of the emails where they said to him straight up that you opened your console, so you voided our warranty.
Mm-hmm.
I actually like it. I don't mind his content at all. Jacob R.
He's another North Carolina guy. He's from Raleigh.
Oh, is he?
Yeah, he's in Raleigh.
Okay.
Yeah. No, he's cool.
He was a good sport too. You did that video kind of ripping him apart. Yeah. Or not, you were pretty mild on him because he's not a bad YouTuber, but
not really, no. He just does a lot of the same over and over.
Yeah.
But it works for him. You know, he's able to make a career out of it. I guess that's cool.
Yep. He does different stuff, but yeah, I think he's got his stuff that he knows what it's gonna do in terms of views and all that. So it's tough to break out, though. I'll give him credit there. I mean, it's tough to get away from what you're known for on YouTube because you try something even the slightest bit new. Sometimes your audience isn't there for it.
Bucky says, "Look up Joey's mom, see what he's getting for her." North Carolina represent. That's right, Batman. Chad says, "Silent Hill 3." Look up Silent Hill 3.
All right, can do that.
Yeah, Broke Daddy, two videos a week minimum. I would try to do one every 3 days, so that ends up being like two a week.
You said for PS3 or for?
He's probably thinking about PS2. That PS2 copy.
$169.99, and that is for game only. Yeah, $189.99. Oh, wow. Okay.
That's a little too much for me.
Yeah.
Games are already scary as it is, man. You don't need to make the price scary, too.
That is true.
Actually, CIB on that is $200, so they're actually under on that. So
really?
That's what price charting says.
Well, they don't have it, so this could be an old price, too. They get that in stock. They're gonna see that and go up to 300.
Probably, yeah.
That's why you always keep them guessing.
What are my stuff's Silent pretty. Hill 1?
Silent Hill 1? You can check that out.
And then Rule of Rose. Rule of Rose is another overpriced game on PS2 that's nowhere near worth what it's going for.
What's, let me see. A lot of options here.
It's that one right there. Third row, go down. Right there. It's out of stock.
Okay.
So price chart is 200 on that CIB.
200 game only. 219. Yeah. All right, that's not outrageous. That's the black label. Greatest hits is $214.99. Yeah, I feel like when it's out of stock, it's probably super outdated on their, you know, in their little database here.
Yeah.
Because they certainly aren't maintaining things on here, which, I mean, how could you? You have all these listings.
Yeah, it's not like they don't have 15 million employees. Well, but they're all busy shipping.
Playing with the resurfacers.
Yeah, they're playing with the resurfacers and they're fucking wheeze up with the sandpaper.
Yep.
Check out.
Plus, they got the constant videos going out too. They're always doing their unboxings, their live unboxings to show what they're getting in new. And then they're doing their little shorts to, you know, combat anybody that's saying anything remotely negative about them. So,
well, I would imagine the reason they do so many videos like that is because if Joey's standing around doing nothing for too long, he might actually have to do something. So he's like, oh, I can't do that. I'm doing a video.
True. Metal Warriors. Yeah. $700, we said, for Super Nintendo.
Whoops. Yeah, all these prices are high.
It's like the mainstream stuff is that they really just try to mark that up because they know that probably the people that aren't super into gaming or are the casuals, if you will, are probably not aware of, you know, true value. So cosmetically flawed, $499. They don't have it though. So a good cartridge is going to set you back cool $700.
Wow. Sweet. See what they want for Clay Fighter Sculptor's Cut. So that game is around 15 loose. Okay. So it's that one on the far left.
That one right there.
Yeah. This was a Blockbuster exclusive.
$17.99 for a good cartridge. Cosmetically flawed, just $13.99. Four reviews, though.
$400 discount.
This is my favorite. This is my favorite. Changing the spelling there just to attract different people.
That's not a Pokemon game. That's a review for a Pokemon game, and obviously yep. That's not. Yeah, yeah. At least they pointed that out. From Luigi.
How can this game be? Luigi B.
Price chart on this game be
so expensive? So I had the privilege to actually play this game when I was younger, and it's not actually that great for a fighter. Its value comes in the name alone. The actual enjoyment that comes with it is very minor. Okay.
Anybody that's ever played that game knows that that shit ain't even worth $20. And I don't care what anybody says.
That's how it goes sometimes.
That game is asshole casserole.
Never played it. I'm going to have to check it out now.
And see, the reason it's so expensive is because it was a rental exclusive to Blockbuster. And the only difference between that and the regular game, as you can see on the right above it, $34.99, that's how much the regular game is. Well, that I mean, it's not even worth that much. That's just what DKOldies charges for it. Mm-hmm. But the Sculptor's Cut is literally the same game. It just has like three or four extra characters.
You get your appearance by Earthworm Jim in there. Only got three. That's not even three stars. Wonderfully not good. There you go. Eric Ring says, endorsement.
Eric says, look up Dragon Fighter for the NES.
You can go with this one, then we'll check out complete. $374.99 for a good cartridge. And these are outdated because it's not in stock, but cosmetically flawed is $259.99. And let's just check out that complete one over there. $11.99 for the complete Dragon Fighter.
Yeah, so that's a seriously old listing because CIB is supposed to be $787 on price chart.
This is probably just a total.
I've never even seen that game.
Me neither.
Or if I did, it's so generic that I forgot. Like, I'm going to name my game Dragon Fighter. Oh, wow. How original. Might as well just call it Dragon Game.
Oh, Game Boy. We didn't even look at Game Boys, but the Pokemon games. Let me just type in Pokemon and we could just wrap it up with some insanity here. So $229 for the Fire Red Edition, Player's Choice on Game Boy Advance. We've got $129.99 over here for Pokemon Red. Emerald, always an expensive one, $339. Is that? Let's see, is that that's good cartridge?
Cartridge only.
All right, so for cosmetic. $120.
That's ridiculous. Wow. I mean, I don't even know why that game's so expensive. I mean, that generation
it's like that sometimes.
Is okay, but
what else? Leaf Green's always kind of high.
That Pokemon trading card game for Game Boy Color is a really good game.
Which one's that here?
It's like one where you actually just play the cards.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but see, it's only like $24.99. That one's on NSO. Soul Silver with the Pokewalker. So just
I never got into Pokemon too much, but I remember playing Pikachu Yellow, Ruby, and Blue. But that's
yeah, Pokemon's awesome, man. That one definitely has the best cover, in my opinion.
Yeah.
They made Pikachu look so cool.
And even the DS ones are pretty pricey too, right?
Yeah. So like Soul Silver is going to be on that third row on the left, $299. That's without the Pokewalker, probably.
Game only, $299. Yeah. So over here, $314.99 for everything.
Yeah, you know, when I worked at Best Buy, man, they had a clearance. They had a clearance end cap with all brand new Soul Silvers and Heart Golds with Pokewalkers. Clearance, wow. $15. There was like 60 copies of the game there.
Oh my god!
And I, you know, obviously. Looking back, you're like, damn, I wish I could have got all those.
Yeah.
Even for me, not to sell them, but like just to be like, hey, look at me. I got like 30 copies of this sealed.
And I'm worth X amount of dollars now.
Yeah.
It'd be a hell of a flex.
The thing was, is like, I didn't even think to buy one just for myself at the time because I was getting out of the DS. That's why it was so cheap because.
Right.
It's not common that Pokemon games are ever that cheap, but
no.
Yeah, that shit was crazy.
I mean, yeah, we were seeing there's nothing that's cheap. Like $29.99 is probably the lowest. All right. Oh, Pokemon Pinball. I actually like Pokemon Pinball, but $22.99, I could see why that's you know, not one of the high ticket items here. But that being said, they don't have any in stock either in good condition. So $22.99 for cosmetically flawed.
Battery not included.
Right. With the rumble. That was one,
you had to put the battery in it.
Yep. Because you want to get that full pinball experience when you hit those flippers and bounce the ball around. So, yeah, it's crazy with the just the prices in general. I mean, this is why I know you're not a big emulation guy, but this is why emulation's doing what it's doing.
Yeah, I mean,
bonus disc for Colosseum.
Yeah, it's one of the most rare.
Yeah.
GameCube. It's not even really a game. You know, it's just like an extra thing that came with I think it was XD or maybe it was Colosseum. I don't remember because I didn't really mess with the GameCube that much. I was a PS2 and Xbox guy.
Okay. Yeah, I was pretty heavy on the GameCube. Emulation is the way to go.